final match of the night. Maneski versus Na'Vi. Let's head into the game.
Long heralded as one of the superstars of Southeast Asia, just wasn't really able to show it that much this year, as Maneski did not do so hot. And on the flip side of things, you have Magical, who I think is a very snowbally player. Like, this guy needs a good laning phase, needs to continue from that as First Blood.
Rangy potato, even a Beastmaster being able to push you nice and late game. Both teams, oh, nice roll in from Zayats. Will be able to kick him back into the shrapnel here. Moon trying to get away, another third round of the shrapnel, and the assassination not actually going to go out. That's because the Ogre's just running at the sniper right now. Thinks about it again, but the bottle hit will allow Moon to stay alive, and it's Zayats who dies instead.
But this is just helping them catch up, not even get ahead. Bottom lane.
They are going to be able to catch KP. They say this Enigma has been farming a bit too long, as he's been spending about half his time in lane, the other half inside of the jungle. An interesting idea from Nico Baby, just spotting the skeletons to push that in. The catapult will get the damage on the tower, but he's going to rotate down to bottom, where he thinks Na'Vi is going to try and show up for a fight, and he would be right, but can they actually punish them? As they get spotted, Raging Potato is going to be able to get the disruption if needed to stop the Earth Spear rollaway, but it's just not. They have too many stuns here. Maneski do manage to get that kill with the Siege Wagon still alive. They can keep going. Sure enough, they're a bit scared to dive this tier 2. They're going to try and go for it now, but Zayats really wants to go for that back line. He wants to stop Moon, but now Moon's going to turn and quickly kill him. Really strong in the five-man in their own right, where Na'Vi's lineup, all three of their cores, are going to need a little bit more time.
Yeah,
Nico Baby, he's going to be Primal Roared here.
He does have reincarnation.
This is very heavy commitment from Na'Vi, so that's going to be the first life. But now Maneski is here. They're going to be able to throw out the Purge on his Zayats, the Soul Catcher as well. They're going to drop the Golem, trying to finish off Nico Baby in his second life. He gets to the high ground disruption.
The
now coming in from behind. Moon and Ninja Boogie, a pair to be able to follow up on the Earth Spirit. Now Magical as well, who's dead. He just tries to lay out as much damage on Lina as possible, even the Golem coming in for a helping hand. But Maneski easily routing Na'Vi once again.
And that was the buyback too from Zayats. I think he assumed that the fight would continue.
That is what his ultimate does, yes.
This is a PSA for Na'Vi.
Yeah.
And for Keen, because I genuinely at this point don't know if they know that, because that's twice now that they try to make that play and they're going to get gone on. There's no ultimates on the side of Na'Vi.
Zayats
got to be careful here.
Does manage to get a really good silence. Oh, look at that ultimate. Oh, Na'Vi, they can turn things around, especially with that Fatal Bond. The take damage over time. They've already finished up the Lina. Raging Potato's just going to die to the assassination of Magical, and Ninja Boogie gets cleaned up as well.
Counted them out a second too late. But still, that was such a head-scratcher of a fight they took.
Absolutely. I mean, the fact that they still had Golem, they still had all their ultimates up, and Maneski didn't have reincarnation, it's pretty obvious that Nico Baby wouldn't want to fight
KP
there. Now KP, he's going to drop the black hole, yes, and he will hold him there for a while, but a Prime Aurora finishes him off, crystallized. Oh, a multicast on him with Lina here as well. Laguna Blade cuts him down. Now he's going to be able to get the Yule Scepter LSA onto Sineko as well. Call it a twofer for Moon, as he managed to help get two of those kills. Blizzy, possibly a third, but it's just hidden away in the trees here.
Like, Wraith King does not come that equipped with armor, which is why he has to go for the AC. I think one time we saw this matchup and he didn't is...
Oh, Zayats.
This
He's
is a
been
nice
very
pickup.
Headstrong about who he wants to go for, just always trying to gun down Moon. Other than that, 1-1-0 has been farming away with the Tanda Midas, now has a Maelstrom and is looking towards BKB or maybe Hurricane Pike. Feels like the safety of just double BKBs. Na'Vi could actually withstand a lot of this pressure from Maneski, but first they have to be able to get there, and Sineko, well, he'll have to see his team on the other side, and it looks like they are gonna have to say goodbye to Blizzy as well. Moon's trying to do just that right now. Not with a Shadow Blade, but with an Invis Rune. As the rest of his team is pushing forward towards where he's at, and they're going to be able to smoke pop onto Blizzy here, quickly taking him down. And Moon goes to Magical somewhere around here, but Magical does manage to get the BKB off first. He may just try and roll forward to get that other Bounty Rune. If he does, though, he's going to be met by Raging Potato, who does get the instant disruption. Nico Baby's here to catch him with the Rate Fire Blast as well. Earth Spirit does not get a chance to roll out of this one.
This is one of the TI best of one syndromes where you're just a little bit afraid to make moves.
Yeah, and is that more beneficial to Na'Vi because we both agreed that they had better late game, or is the timings of AC and Ashiva's around the same time for this Lina and Wraith King, is that just going to completely negate Na'Vi's farm on their big physical damage course?
I don't know if it'll completely negate it, but
disruption, good save. Rage Potato also managed to get the purge. If Yule Scepter, no stun to follow that up because they knew Crystallize was going to use BKB, but now they have to get rid of Golem by the Primal Roar. Assassination,
oh,
able to finish up. They do manage to get the black hole right on the edge.
They all roll,
and he can't get to KB whatsoever, but they had no damage to be able to follow it up. Nico Baby was just a little bit too far away. A great upheaval, slowing everybody down. Magical responding to Moon, but Moon, with the double damage, he can actually fight through that BKB, but Magical does manage to get to the high ground, so instead he'll turn back to help finish up Zayant. Multiple buybacks from Mineski. They need to be able to get more out of this one. They do manage to get Snako. A self Yule's trying to defend against Crystallize. Best possible disruption there as well. Soul Catch of Crystallize a little bit low. Oh no, an LSA actually barely clips, and they do manage to get the shot on Crystallize, but Moon is still dead. Nico Baby trying to finish off another round, and the Shadow Poison to be able to finish off Crystallize. But Nico Baby in his second life, look at him, he's just getting poked to death by Magical. Pew, pew, pew! Takes down the carry of Mineski, and now Ninja Boogie will fall as well. Mineski buying back to try and take that fight. They said this is going to be where we break Na'Vi. And what a big pop there from Raging Potato. They just send Moon go get one of those bounty runes. He's going to try and push in the mid lane, but Magical, he's not slowing down one bit with this Aegis. He's going to quickly chop down. Look at that initiation. Because of the Hawk, they actually spotted out where Raging Potato was. Mineski did not plan very well.
And the best part about playing Cypher in a game like this, Cap, is you have so much that can frontline and initiate for you.
And I mean, just look at the way he's just chopping down this tier 3 between Inner Beast.
Look at the force step,
the aggressive force step. Does manage to get him up into the high ground, but there's the Golem drop. It's going to be Ninja Boogie down first. Nico Baby in the back line. They do have the black hole.
Cancel.
Quickly canceled by the assassination. And that's 3 dead of Mineski with no buyback. That's why they were so low to take a fight. But when it finally comes to them from Na'Vi, Mineski quickly gift wiped, and that could just be it without buybacks.
And this was our concern and the panel's concern. If you throw out the hole like that and it doesn't completely change the course of the fight, your hero's gonna feel way too slow.
Oh, look at that. Bots.
They know there's no buyback.
Yep.
Nobody bought back, and there's no hole even if they had it. They've got Aegis, they've got the Solar Crescent Sniper, Na'Vi, they've got everything up. They're daring Mineski to do something about it.
Mineski, though, only need a few more seconds to be able to get there.
You gotta fight now.
Overextend themselves on the throne. We'll have to see as they make the initiation on Blizzy. Trying to finish him off, not quite enough. So now they have to deal with a Cypher who's trying to hit the throne right now. That is gonna be Blizzy down from the Laguna Blade. They're gonna be able to catch the Cypher as well as force to use the BKB. That's the Aegis. He won't have the magic immunity in his second life. This is trouble for Na'Vi. They're gonna have to leave Magical behind. They took the tier 4s down. But did they just throw away so much of the game? They just gave away a wicked 6 streak to Nico Baby.
See what they can get, but they've got to be so careful because they're all-encompassing T-fight ability.
Oh, they found the Moon! They managed to get the assassination, give it enough vision for Blizzy to be able to get the Primal Roar in this. But Na'Vi, they chose not to take that fight around the Raid King. They're instead going to push into the top lane. Let Magical start laying down that damage onto the tier 3.
And this is what led them to getting Rax in the first place at bottom.
Got the disruption, but now Raging Potato in some trouble. He do manage to get the force staff away, slowing down the Sven, but they're going to use the Primal Roar as well. He does have buyback. And with this heavy commitment coming out from Na'Vi, they need to be able to get outside of the base, back to safety, but Nico maybe just won't let him. He's going to stay on top of Crystallize. Now the BKB is already used, and Magical's at half health as well. He's going to go for Sineko, but that will summon a fresh Golem. Mineski need to be careful with this one. There's the Golem with the Fatal Bonds as well. Nico Baby tied up to Moon. Doesn't care though. Keeps on marching forward. Does manage to get the stun, a follow-up stun as well onto Magical, but Moon has been forced away. A blink back now from Nico Baby, but Zayas sees that opportunity to be able to slow down the heroes.
If he's gone down,
to finish up the Enigma as well. The roll in from Zayas managed to nail the Wraith King, but dodge another stun with the disruption. Moon, now he's the one who seeks weakness as he blinks forward, but Zayas has already rolled a little bit too far away for the old scepter. Sam goes for Ranger Potato, who does manage to get the purge, but there is a roll away from Zayas. Poison after poison. Zayat sitting up is actually going to be able to get the push in. Two-man stun because of that, but the Abyssal Blade out onto with the Soul Catcher as well. That's a lot of damage, but will they have enough to be able to finish him up? They will! That is good enough!
Hey, need to get out now.
On his second life, is going to be able to look for more. Zyance is going to be caught by the old scepter. Sniper's actually fighting this one. That's crazy talk. Magical sitting in the trees, but that's because Blizzy is going to be able to lock down Nico, baby. Nico, baby, they need to be able to save him here with the Solar Crest. He's getting away. Magical one last shot. Force staffing forward. This is crazy. He wants this kill so badly. He's willing to put his body on the line to get it.
I mean, they're around here.
I mean, they went for the hot cooldown, so they're hoping all about the vision right now.
Yeah, they're hoping that Moon comes back. Tries to deal with this wave.
Yeah, and he's here.
Can they make the jump?
They're going to be able to get the Prime Reward, see if they can burst him down real quick, and they've got him. Na'Vi planned that one out for like the last minute and a half, but Blizzy, oh, the black hole is going to catch him right on
the
edge
too?
Of that TP. That's the gem on the deck, and immediately KP goes for the refresher in sight of Na'Vi. With all those Eidolons, like Mineski could just tear down buildings super fast. We're gonna try and get a fight around the Roshan. They are able to get this purge initiation with a 4x multicast. This poor Sven just got taken out by
gone.
Luna Blade. And now Moon, he refreshes up. He's got a fresh BKB, a fresh Laguna Blade, and it's got somebody, a Na'Vi's name on it.
They're gonna go for it right now.
Oh. Oh, Zyance with the Aghanim Scepter is going to kick Ninja Boogie into the tier fours.
He's okay.
Force Dash with the Ethereal Blade is actually going to allow him to be able to get away. The Disruption being used out to be able to buy the Wraith King time, but Magical, very safe in the backside, is able to poke at Nico Baby, trying to bring him low enough that they can take away that reincarnation for free, and then they can make the real commitment. But Mineski looking to be able to force the buybacks out of Crystallize. They've got 30 seconds. And the Glyph is now down. Raging Potato found his initiation. He's going to go for the Sniper with the Soul Catcher as well. The Aeon just allowing to be able to live through this. A Laguna Blade. That's who had the name on it. It was Magical. But where's the buybacks coming out from Na'Vi? Now they have the Chaotic Offering on the ground to be able to slow down some of these heroes. They go for the buybacks, but still, Crystallize holds onto his. And look at Zyance right now. He is burrowing deeper into the tree, seeing if he can get a positioning for another pickoff like he tried earlier on Ninja Boogie.
I mean, what a turnaround from what this game looked like half an hour ago.
Once again, they're going to be able to force out the BKB on Blizzy. Blizzy, trying to stay alive, is going to be saved by the Earth Spirit. Zyance is pulls him back, and that is just enough. No!
It hits!
The last flame from Moon gets another one, another buyback out of Na'Vi.
Top lane, Nico Baby, he's daring them. He's saying, I've got two lives. Do something about this.
Crystallize, he's the only one with two lives on the side of Na'Vi. Where's he going to make his jump? Rage of Potato, he'll always find the jump first. He's going to be able to get Disruption on the Sniper once again. He is going to be saved, though.
But by Ninja just run from the
shot comes out from the Assassination. They're going to give up Megas here. He's Mineski going to go all the way for the throne. They jump to the back line. They do manage to get Sinego. Sinego with the Chaotic Offering. He's dead. He doesn't get off the goals. Now the Tier 4s are falling, and Na'Vi are going to have to take the 4 versus 5 with no buybacks.
Look at this. They're going for the base.
They're rolling. It looks like Mineski, they're actually just trying to go for the throne as quick as possible. Mineski is there to be able to respond. The throne is dying. Na'Vi crystallized. He can't hold it in time. The Raidfire Blast will stop it. And it looks like Mineski, they've got it in the bag. They'll finish up the throne while simultaneously defending their own. That's it. Mineski, take it just as we pass over an hour. They hold strong. They hold discipline. And they finish off Na'Vi.
And you could see KP with that look of disbelief.